traditional political parties who have finished their campaigns have to campaign for another 3 or 4 days. That's additional cost that was not factored in before. And they are also going to remobilize their polling agents nationwide.
But can we quantify in money terms what all this boils down to? How much money are we talking about in this instance?
Well, INEC will have to put out in the public space later what were their cost of remobilization. I don't have those figures. Yeah. But what I know is that the budget approved for them by the National Assembly was a fixed sum. Whether inside that entire framework there is an adjustment for this, I wouldn't say National Assembly is any postponement. But if this additional cost is not covered by the budget, then it means that there's a fiscal deficit in the country.
People have different understanding of what you mean by
opportunity cost.
Yeah.
Interesting. Okay. The opportunity cost is what you are losing, the revenue and the activity you are losing if the election was not scheduled. In Nigeria, for those 2.5 days, economic activity and revenue didn't come, largely. So, calculated in terms of our GDP, Nigeria's GDP is $446 billion.
Yeah.
If you go to the next slide, $446 billion. You divide it by 365 and multiply it by 2.5 days, convert it to Naira, 305 Naira, you are getting about 933 billion for those 2.5 days. Now, that's a lot of revenue. That's a lot of GDP. And yes, we know that the postponement under this heading.
But we don't seem to have a cost to the direct cost. So can we get a proper tabulation if only we have the opportunity cost and the consequential cost?
No,
because we don't have that.
Yeah, we don't have this. Because a lot of the information has to come from INEC. It's because most of it is public sector expenditure. That's why I put a question mark to it. On the consequential side, there are several costs, but this particular cost is 1.61% of the all share index on the first working day, Monday the 18th of February, after the postponement. That shows you the impact of investor concerns. The activity was less, just 1.61% of the all share index, giving 196 billion. That is a consequence of the postponement. That's a consequential cost. So we can put a figure to this. And this, if you put this together, you're getting about 1.1 trillion.
Okay.
About 1.1 trillion. But that's not all of the consequential cost. You talk about the consequential cost.
So we have a lot more costs here now.
Before that, could you go back 2 slides? Good. I mentioned opportunity costs.
Yeah.
I mentioned direct costs. Yeah. I mentioned the consequential costs. There's some other consequential costs which I have here. For instance, across the country today, you have a number of foreign, regional, and local election observers. Many of them are going to stay longer. Another 1 week. They stay 1 week. They're going to pay hotel bills. That's a cost. Luckily, the federal government has waived their visa fees, so they didn't have to pay for visa extension.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a revenue or help that would have come to Nigeria. But that's gone. Again, as a consequential cost,
put a figure to that.
Please kindly click on the red subscribe button below this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Note: subscription is free.
God bless you as you subscribe to our channel.